So now I'm going to show you how to make that concrete look using the naturally aged paint system architecture, which is that concrete look that I showed you earlier on the corbel. I want to show you how to make that on this little decorative wood bracket from Woodcraft in 4 easy steps. This is one of my favorite paint systems. I just love how incredible the look comes out when you're done. So you start with the wood. Just make sure that it's clean and wiped off. We're going to start with the first step. Using a brush, we're going to coat the surface with the tan. And this is the tan high-impact pigment from Tattered Angels. And we're going to use a bigger brush for this so we can cover more surface. We're going to let some of the areas pool and not cover every little area either, because we want some of the other colors in our steps down the road to fill in those areas as well. But we're just going to get a good overall tan background on this wood. I know this is probably barely noticeable on here. You can see a little bit of variation there. So we come in here. You can just use a nice big brush for this part of it. Make sure you do the top. You don't have to worry about the back. I just want to cover the majority of the surface. I'm going to have to get some more of this because I've just about used it all. I'm going to let some of that pool right there. I'll get some of the other color from my other project on there. I need to wipe my hands. Let that sit for just a quick moment. I just needed to wipe my hands, sorry, with some of the dark color from the last one that I did. We'll put that away for right now and make sure we got it all covered good. So the second step, we're just going to arbitrarily spray the boardwalk glimmer mist onto the project, leaving some of the areas without it. And then we're going to blot it in with a brush and dry. So here's our boardwalk glimmer mist. When you're using your mist, don't shake them up and down. That creates bubbles and air in there and makes it splotchy. You just want to go, just do it around in a circle, just kind of side by side. So we're just going to spray different areas. It's going to kind of pull together with the tan. Make sure you get the top. Don't forget the edges. And we're going to blot that with a brush. Another brush. Just blot it. A big one. Like a little brush because it just gives a little bit of texture on it. Before it dries. And it just blends tan and boardwalk color together. Just a little more tan up in here. You just gotta kind of eyeball it a little bit. Don't be afraid. So it gives it the look. Just a little bit on there. Blot it a little bit. All right, and then step 3, we're gonna spray a very small amount of Valencia, the chalkboard, which is the white, about 4 inches from the project in a semi-concentrated area, and then we're gonna blot and dry. This is what gives it that real concrete look. So some areas are concentrated, some are just misted. So we can have that variance. Let's not forget the top again. We're gonna blot and dry. You know, it's not looking like a lot yet. Takes a number of steps to get the final look. Bear with me. Your surface is getting a little wet here. Then we're going to spray the chalkboard about 5 to 6 inches away from the project in a hairspray motion. And that's the blue. So you want to get pretty far from it. 4 to 5 inches, so it's not too concentrated. You can come in and do just a little tad, just up in the corner. A little variance in there. We're going to blot it with the brush. That just gives a little variation in color there. Forget the top again. We need to get some blue on there. It's just amazing the look that it gives it. And I know that this doesn't show it super well. I'll have still pictures in the sunlight so you can see it real well. But this piece of wood was just plain old piece of wood just a moment ago. And look how beautiful we've made it using this unbelievable paint system by Tattered Angels. And the wood just took it well. You see that it didn't soak it all in like crazy. It just stayed on the surface. Blended really well in this wood. And it turned out just beautiful. It's really close to the bigger piece. You can see that they're pretty close. When it dries, it takes on a little more color. So I hope that helps you in using the faux finish system, the paint system. And there are many different kinds. There is a weathered birch, and of course we have, you know, the weathered bronze, and all kinds of different ones that are available with Tattered Angels. And you can use these, again, on paper, on wood, on many surfaces. It's a really great product. It's all water-based product. It's got a fast dry time. And in addition, because it is the Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist, it does leave this little tiny sheen that you're not going to see in this video. So it's got just a little bit of a glimmer to it, which gives it an added effect. Well, I hope that helped to inspire you, and you have a wonderful day. In this tutorial, we're going to be using the Naturally Aged Paint System Precious Stone in the granite finish. I'll try to show you here, best I can, the effect that we're trying to achieve. We're going to use the 4 easy steps, which comes with every set of paints that you get in the paint system. And we're just going to follow them one by one. And I have never done this particular one yet, so we're going to kind of do it together. I'm just going to use a small brush, and we're going to use the satchel color, the satchel glaze by Tattered Angels. And we're just going to blot on desired surface in a random fashion. So we're just going to do it randomly. Kind of give it a blotchy look. Don't be stingy with it. You can use a fan brush or a regular brush. I feel like I have a little more control with just a regular brush. Just get that kind of pooled look in the background. I know this is kind of hard as you're going along to envision the final project, but it really does end up being this beautiful finish when you're done. So don't be afraid, because you can move this around a little bit. We can add to. We'll just put that aside for a moment. While the satchel glaze is still wet, we're going to add the iron in a hairspray motion, and that is the Tattered Angels Iron Glimmer Mist. We're going to shake it side by side. Okay, you don't want to use too much, as it will create too dark of a look for granite. So concentrate on some areas more than others. It is best to leave some of the areas blank. The more uneven, the better. So let's spray off to the side. We are literally going to do this random. This blotchiness, I try to put blot it in with the paintbrush pretty quickly so we don't have as much blotchiness. Just kind of gives the look in the background of the darker areas. No two pieces are going to be alike. Like I said, I've never done this finish, so we are going to do it together here. I showed you some examples of the other ones, and they turned out beautiful. So don't be afraid. You can always add more. I just like to try to take some of the blotchiness off. Alright, now we're going to take some of the plumeria, and we're just going to do a tapping and dripping method using the plumeria. So we're just going to tap it on there, get it nice and wet. See where I'm just tapping the brush. Super wet, let it drip on there. Nice coverage. Tapping works best because it kind of goes really random for us. This is just a little bit of a hint of color. We're not going crazy with the plumeria. I just love the mess this makes. This is an incredible way to finish wood pieces like this. You can do it on paper. You can do it on just so many different surfaces. It's wonderful. So I'm just going to blot it in a little bit. Just kind of like how I did the other. So it gives a little blended without taking away the blotchiness of it. So we're going to put the plumeria aside. I think we've got plenty on there for the look. I just want to fill in a few spots here. You want to leave some of it natural to pick up some of the colors when we blend it at the end. I know it doesn't look like a lot right now, but it's just it's a step. Each step makes it look more and more. You'll want to dry this completely, and if you feel that you need more plumeria, then that's when you can add it. Just feel like we need a little bit more color in here. I'm going to let this dry. Now that we have the piece all dry, we're going to use the Cookies and Cream Glam. I'm actually going to put the lid back on and shake it up again. It's been sitting for a little bit. You always want to make sure you shake these really well so you can get a good color covering. I'm going to use a bigger brush for this one. I'm actually just going to pour it right on the brush. Now we're just going to cover the entire surface with this Cookies and Cream, which will kind of give us our last color in the system here. Went a little dark on the iron, so this is going to come out a little darker, but it still gives a nice little granite look to it. I'm just going to continue to cover it with cookies and cream. Now I got a little pull of it to take from. Let's just cover this really good. This is going to fill in all the little spots that we didn't fill in with the other colors. Give it that wood part of it. And that's all it takes. It's still wet, as you can see. We'll have to dry it. And that gives just a faux granite look on this decorative bracket. I need to do the top of it. So I'll go back over and do the top as well. Thank you for watching, and I hope that helped you to use these or to figure out ways of using these paint systems for faux painting on your wood projects?